Hello friends, this is Dhrupal. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, I am going to show you what is the importance of this custom annotations and how to create a custom annotations. So if you are a senior Java developer or might be an intermediate Java developer, let's say SDE2 or SDE3, so definitely you should encounter that kind of questions. So how to create a custom annotations, or might be what is the meanings of the retentions policy inside that custom annotations, or might be what is the different target types and their meanings. So definitely I'll discuss each and every part of this video. So let's start this video. But if you are new, try to suggest you just subscribe my channel, because lots of things are coming in the pipeline. And second things, like if you have any doubts, just let me know in the comment sections. So yes, in order to create the custom annotations, what you need to do, so I'll tell you the first step. So let's say if you have a package already, so just right click it. If you are using IntelliJ or might be that Eclipse, so just there is a new, and you can see like a there is a annotations, so you can give any name. So let's say this is the name, my annotations, right? So now you can see my annotations has been created. So now what is the syntax? So if you want to create your own without help of the any of the IDE, let's say if you are writing in a simple Notepad plus or Notepad, and then you want to compile it with the help of Java compiler, so that time you can use public@interface, that is the annotations for creating the custom annotations, and then your annotations name. And then second things, you have to mention the type and different things related to the your custom annotations. So now let's say if your annotations is a kind of a documented type. So documented type means, let's say whenever your class documentations will be generated with the help of Java docs, so that time it will be shown. So in that case, you can use @documented that annotations on the top of your custom annotations. And second thing is @inherited. So definitely I'll show you in the example. So inherited means, so let's say these annotations you have created, and now if you want to use any of the class of this annotations, now you want whatever the child class that has been extended from that class, so that there should be available on that annotation, so that time you can use a @inherited. But if you want like a whatever the specific class is going to use your custom annotations, so that time you don't need to use the @inherited. So @inherited, the main purpose is if the child class who is going to use that annotation, so that should they can also see the facility of that annotation. So that is the purpose of @inherited. But most important part is a retentions policy. So what is that retentions policy? Retention policy, okay. So there is a three types of retentions policy. So let me show you. So one type is a class, another type is a runtime, and another type is a source. So first of all, let me discuss about the source. So source means nothing but you can think about your source code, whatever you are writing. So that is means it will not be available in the compile time, or it will be not available in the runtime. So whenever your code will be compiled, so that time it will not be checked by the compiler. So let me give you one example. Let's say you have used a @suppress warnings, that annotations given by the core Java. So if you do mouse over @suppress warning, that annotations, you will be seeing that retentions policy is a source level. Why? Because that will not going to check by the compiler. But apart from that, there is a class. So few of the annotations is there, so that will check by the compiler. So that time you can mark it retentions policy dot is a class. But if you want to make it available by the runtime, I mean JVM should be accepted, so that time you can use a runtime. So most of the cases we have seen in Spring, so they have introduced that kind of facility like a dependency injections, whatever annotations you are using, most of the cases we have seen like it, they have used a runtime, because that is going to use in the runtime check by the JVM. So let me show you the example. So now this is the Spring Boot applications annotations. If you do the mouse over, so now first of all Spring Boot configurations, auto configurations, component scan, so those are the annotations that is included in that annotations as Spring Boot applications annotations is a composite annotations. But the main thing is, as I said, retentions policy. So you can see the retentions policy is a runtime, okay, not in a source or class. So there is a three type of retentions policy, already I explained to you. So now inherited and documented, as I mentioned, like any of the class, let's say it is a inherited is given, so any of the class, child class, which is extend that Spring batch app start this class, so that they can also see the facility of that Spring Boot applications annotations. So similarly, documentations is the purpose of the documentations things. So now that second most important part, as I mentioned, target. So target is where you want to apply these annotations. The main purpose is where you want to apply these annotations. So now let's say I want to apply these annotations in the field level, nothing but a variable. I want to apply these annotations in the class level or constructor level or method level. So you can specify those values. So let me show you here. So in this case, you can see that target type value is a type. So type is a one type of a target value. It can be applied anywhere. Either you can apply for the class level, method level, or in a field level, or even constructor interface any level. So type is a that kind of a generic say value. So now target, let me in my case that is a target. Now value, let's say this is a field level, so I want to give a, it's a field level, okay, element dot type dot field level. So that is means this is applicable in a field level. So now this is how we can create a custom annotations. Now if you want to put any of the field, as I mentioned, these annotations will be applicable in the field level. Let's say this field level, my field level name is, let's say this is a string, okay, emp name, okay, emp name, then this, now default, okay, now let's say default value is a name. So now why default is applicable? So let's say if you want to declare any of the fields and if you want some default value should be there, so that time you can use a default that you want and you can mention the value. So any of the class or field which is going to use that annotations, that is my annotations, so if that employee name is there, that field, so that default value should be debug if they will not use it. Let's say integer is nothing, so I am not assigning anything. Now string, let's say gift id, okay, now default value equals to 126, my department value. So now this is how we can actually create any custom annotations. Now how you can use that custom annotations in your class. Let's say this is my class, let's say example annotation. Now in that part, so as I mentions, okay, integer, as I said, what is my annotation, so let's say integer, right, and this is my example annotations. So now integer age, and now I have made it a kind of a annotations, okay, my annotations. So this is actually my annotations I have created. You can see the error. Why this is error? Because they are saying like a missing attributes is missing. So missing attributes, it's nothing but a, let's say, whatever the attributes you didn't provide a value. So now in case of age, so I didn't provide any default value, but in case of emp name I provided Debu, and I provided department ID, that is 126. So now when I try to use that annotations in my field level, because if you see that is applicable in the field level, so that's what I can see, like when I am using that annotations, it is asking you should provide that default value. But let's say if I am going to use that annotations in the class level, it will going to give an error, because this is applicable on the field level. But let's say if I change from field to type, but it will not going to give any error. Let's save it and let's come to here. Now you can see that error is gone. So this is how we can write a custom annotations. But the most important part, what I can conclude in from this example, like you should have to understand like what is the retentions policy, as I mentioned, like nothing but the visibility of that annotations. So mostly that is a source level, class level and runtime. And second thing is the target where you want to apply, whether you want to apply that annotations in that class level, field level, or might be any of the method level or constructor level. And documented and inherited is a kind of a, I can say, a metadata type of annotations. So if you want to use it, you can use it, but it's a depend on you based on the requirement. Although inherited, there is a special meaning, like if the child class want to access it, but documented, it's a kind of a documentation's purpose that will be using by the Java docs. So that's all in this video. If you have any issues or any errors or any doubts, just let me know in the comment section. Definitely I'll try to help you out. And yes, don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching my video. Bye. I'll see you in next tutorial.